welcome back to Mr Foreman's workshop for another awkward episode of fumbling about in the dark with little clue as to what's actually going on. Well, we do have a plan of attack on our Land Rover restoration here. We're going to start with the steering linkages, and then the big question is going to be answered: what lives in there? How is the condition of the housing that the steering relay lives in? That's going to give us a good idea of what the future holds. By all accounts, these guys are apparently quite a bear to remove. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh, my Pitman arm puller is not wide enough to fit on. Oh, there it goes. There it goes. You can see this last bastard here, how it's like rock solid up against the springs. And then you try to push it lower to get more clearance, and it bounces up against the diff, and it doesn't look like it's going to come out, but it will if you give it a violent twist. There we go, that's good to know. That saves you doing a whole lot of extra work to try and get it out. It can be done. Now we have off our various steering linkages, the next logical step would be to take these guys here off to replace them with new ones, but before that happens, to make sure that we get them as close to possible as they once were, we're going to measure from the center of here to the center of there on all three of them and record those measurements. And then when we work out which one's left hand, right hand thread, we're going to count the turns and record that as well. We can paint these up, clean them up, then reattach the new ones, and hopefully it all fits together back the way it was. Center. Twenty-five and a half inches. That'll definitely pay to clean these shreds up, I think. Work out which direction. Record them. One, two, three, four, five, six. With the steering linkages all removed, it's now time to extract the infamous steering relay. Now, we do have a bit of shit built up around the threads of the nuts and the bolts that's going to have to be scraped out before we do it. I have heard that these things can get corroded in there quite badly and be quite a bear to remove, so I have a few plans of attack. Once we've got the lower arm off and all the nuts and bolts out, we're going to try with a piece of wood and a hammer. Gentle approach. Failing that, we're going to see if we can get a jack up underneath it, and that's why I left the wheels and the diff and the springs on for that extra weight. Then, if that fails, we might have to wheel it out and get some heavy machinery in to pin this and try again with a jack. And plan four will be devised if we have to go that far. Having just removed these two bolts from the top and the four that sit in what I call a flange plate underneath, I'm hoping that's all we have to do, and we're ready to begin some gentle beating. It's not going well. Oh
I can't say I'm really over the moon about this idea, but it's a good thing about being chief editor of the films. If something goes really wrong, I'm not going to show it. Plan C is not going real well. That's a heavy bucket of gravel. The full weight is there, and that steering relay is rusted in so well that that alone is supporting all that. I didn't really think Plan C was gonna fail. Rocks. Next stage of these remarkable plans I'm coming up with is I've chained the axle to the chassis. So now when the chassis lifts, it's going to have to bring the axle and the wheels with it. I've put the double seats from the back of the disco on the chassis, just to add a little more, and a spare tire, which is going to do completely nothing, onto the bucket. And now we're going to see if we get any love from that. Ah, it's not showing any signs of wanting to give way at all. Holy shit. Now we've got a chain wrapping around the lift arm and underneath the tractor so that it'll stop it from coming up. It's just lifting up the tractor. That's all it's doing. This is a formidable opponent, to say the least. So you see the truck's back in the garage and that steering relay hasn't budged, not even a squillionth of an inch. Still in position. Now I did say this was going to be called the front bit. But if the name's changed and it's now called the steering relay, a woeful tale, you'll know that the content's probably going to fill up the entire video, if not several. Yes, this is quite worrisome. Now I do have a plan E formulating in what I call a brain, and that'll be a surprise for later. But I think we're going to continue with the liquid wrench soaking, maybe now for, I think maybe 10 years. So I'll see you then. The harsh reality is this steering relay is going to take some work to get out. And rather than just waste time, I think we'll proceed by ripping apart all the front hubs, take off the springs, the diff, renew all the parts and seals and bits and pieces we need to, scrape back the chassis to bare metal and paint that, put it all back together, and then come back to this bastard later on. Thank you. have some fabrication we need to do to put together my invention. Now, anyone who's seen me on power tools will know it's quite a terrifying experience at the best of times. We're going to take this to a whole new level. This is a welding gun. That is a welder. And this is an instruction booklet. Hold on to your hats. Well, it's probably a good opportunity to marvel at my skills as a welder. There's a particularly good one here I'd like to show you. There. See that? Just been wandering off on my own little tangent, down through the metal, not even on the seam. There's another good one. Oh, there, we've got a few little dimes in there, what's called dimes, with a few pits and holes that, yes, you'd be doubting the structural integrity of anything I'm doing. So I'm almost thinking I should start up my own welding YouTube channel on how to. It'd be a real shit show, wouldn't it? Quite a train wreck. Probably become quite popular. Okay, let us continue. Invention is complete. It's a masterpiece. We did have a few things to work around, such as this bar here got in the way of this strut, and that probably supported a winch at one stage. We had to work around that, and also this battery support is in the way as well, and that's welded to the chassis we can't remove, so we had to jimmy-rig things to get it to sit. So it is now is the test to see what breaks first. The chassis, the jack, the steering relay, or my contraption. This is the other invention I made to accessorize my cage. It slots over that central spline that I've already destroyed and pushes under the full underside of the steering relay, and then the jack will come in on that plate there. That's it. It's called a, it doesn't have a name. Oof. All right, I think it might be time. We've got the full force of the jack. I can't push it down anymore, and that steering relay isn't budging. After all, that plan Z has failed. Have a look here, what the cage has done to the chassis cross member there. It's pushed it in and bowed it out at the front there. So it's just damaging the chassis. That was a 6-ton jack pushing up against that, and it's still jammed in there tight. So I'm gonna have to come up with a plan Z.2, I think. And I haven't formulated that just yet. Another thing going on too, it looks like the jacks pushed up the entire relay with the chassis as well, creating like a concave kind of effect. I wouldn't be surprised actually if this entire front end might have to be cut off and new stuff put on, if it's even available.
remove this whole front panel there. That had to go, it was in very bad shape. What I'd really like to do is cut off that front cross member here and just get rid of it and replace it, but as I cannot, because you can't get those parts, I'm gonna be stuck with what I've got. I'm a little bit perplexed, there's not a lot holding it in there. Well, we shall keep persevering and try and work out what to do. That was the big powerful spring that lives in the relay. And we've made some progress. We've definitely got the thing moving. However, there's a certain stage where it just gets caught. Now, I think the bottom of it has a little sort of like a knob on the end, so to speak. So obviously with a lot of rust and gunk under there, as you can see on the little bit that's exposed, I think trying to push it up is a losing battle, as we've seen already. As we've mangled this entire contraption, I'm now considering the option of cutting the top off if I can and hammering it in a downward direction. Angle butt blade. That's how you do it. Well, if you're trying to remove a steering relay yourself, I hope you don't have the troubles I did. So there we have Exhibit A. You can see the bottom is slightly wider. So that's catching on all the crud as it tries to pull its way out of its little housing. And it's just not good. So having cut the top off and knocking it down, it came out quite easy. Although it's a shame, this is an original unit. They're quite expensive to buy. So I would have really liked to have kept it, but it's not to be. Wow, so that draws a conclusion to this episode. We didn't come very far, did we? And it was a woeful tale. In the next episode, we're going to proceed with our endeavors. We're going to try doing some panel beating to get that cross member in order. And really, just see how far we get.